Halo semuanya, balik lagi di videonya Velia di Polandia. Video ini adalah video sambungan dari belajar bahasa Polandia ke part yang ke 5. Dan maaf banget kalau video part 4 itu sudah 2 bulan yang lalu dan sekarang baru upload lagi. Tolong dimaafkan. I apologize because like some people asking about the, like when we will have the
sorry for being late but a lot of things to prepare.
Okay, jadi buat kalian yang udah ngeklik video ini, thank you banget sebelumnya udah ditonton dan lanjut ditonton terus kalau kalian mau belajar bahasa Polandia. Okay, yang part kelima ini kita akan belajar tentang days and months atau hari dan bulan dalam bahasa Polandia. Oke, dan masih bersama Mr. Adam, guru kita, untuk di video ini. Oke, dan sebelum kalian lanjut, jangan lupa videonya, tolong subscribe channelnya aku, channelnya Velia di Polandia, dan di like dan di komen. Oke, jangan lupa itu ya. Oke, dan sekarang kita mulai. Let's start from Senin atau Monday.
Poniedziałek.
Poniedziałek. Tuesday.
Wtorek.
Wtorek. Selasa, wtorek. Rabu.
Środa.
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 Środa. Kamis.
Czwartek.
Czwartek. Jumat.
Piątek.
Piątek. Sabtu.
Sobota.
Sobota. Minggu.
Niedziela.
Niedziela. Okay. Mungkin ini agak sedikit cepat, but we can repeat again. From Monday, from Senin.
Poniedziałek.
Poniedziałek.
Wtorek.
Wtorek.
Środa.
Środa.
Czwartek.
Czwartek.
Piątek.
Piątek.
Sobota.
Sobota.
Niedziela.
Niedziela. Nah, itu dia. It's not that difficult, yeah?
Not that difficult, but it has a very it has the Polish signs in them, so it might be a little problematic at the beginning, but
yes,
it's not as bad.
Yeah, but it's totally different than
it is
than
totally
English,
different,
right?
Or I think English. Every language have completely different names,
yeah,
and it might be a little complicated at the beginning, but yeah, it is what it is, unfortunately.
Yeah, dari yeah, from Indonesian as well. Like if you know the days in Indonesia, mm-hmm. It's like Senin, Selasa,
Rabu,
Kamis.
I had a lot of problems at the beginning.
Jumat, Sabtu, Minggu. That's completely different than in English, right? Okay, that's days. Kita sudah ini di hari-hari. Jadi kalian bisa hafalin itu kalau kalian mau ke Polandia, itu kan penting banget nih kalau kalian sekolah, kalian kerja, atau kalian tinggal di sini. Kalau kalian mau buat janji, appointment, dan lain-lain kan harus tahu. You have to know.
Yes.
Hari apa, ya. Kalau misalnya kalian jalan-jalan ke toko atau apa, kan pasti ada hari-harinya. Dan itu kalian harus tahu dari Senin sampai hari Minggu. Karena di sini kan penting gitu kalau misalnya kalian di Polandia, kalian bisa tahu basic bahasa Polandia. That will be very helpful and useful to know.
Even when you have some any kind of schedules or stuff,
yeah,
you will have the little like shortened versions of those.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't know the full name, you will have a lot of problems to figure out what's the day.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. But it's kalau in the beginning it was really hard for me, but it's okay. Like setelah sekian lama, nanti kalian bisa benar-benar bisa apa ngapalin itu gitu. It can be memorized easily.
Like everything.
Well, okay.
Learning language after all.
Yes. Terus sekarang setelah hari di bahasa Polandia, sekarang kita lanjut ke part 2 di video ini, yaitu months atau bulan. Yang pertama, bulan pertama Januari.
Stycień.
Stichen. Februari?
Lute.
Lute. Maret? Maret?
Marzec.
Marzec. April?
Kwiecień.
Kwiecień. May?
Mai.
Mai. That's easy.
That's easy.
Mai. Juni?
Czerwiec.
Czerwiec.
Not so easy.
Not so easy. That's my birthday month.
That's your birthday.
Czerwiec.
Czerwiec.
Czerwiec. Czerwiec. Juli?
Lipiec.
Lipiec.
That's my birthday.
Lipiec.
Lipiec.
Augustus?
Sierpień.
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 Sierpień. September?
Wrzesień. That's the top
oh,
one.
That's the difficult one. September? Wrzesień.
Wrzesień.
Wrzesień. October?
Październik.
Październik.
Unfortunately, the next two are quite hard. So it's październik.
Październik. November?
Listopad.
Listopad.
It literally means the leaves are falling from the trees.
Oh, so yeah, November is the autumn, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And then December?
Grudzień.
Grudzień. Ooh, we already finished 12 months. What do you think? So fast. Jadi gimana kalian? Menurut kalian gimana? Susah atau enggak? Okay, jadi sekarang kita harus mulai dari awal. Let's start from January.
Styczeń, luty, marzec, kwiecień, maj, czerwiec, lipiec, sierpień, wrzesień, październik, listopad, grudzień.
Ooh la la, oh my god, yes, that's not so easy, but it's okay. Karena kalau di bahasa Indonesia kan hampir-hampir sama kayak bahasa Inggris ya. In Indonesia it's also similar than in English.
It's very similar to English, yes.
January, January, mm-hmm. February, February, March, Maret, April, April,
May,
yeah, Mai, May, June, Juni, mm-hmm. July, July. So it's easy for me to memorize it,
yes,
in English.
Yes, I had
too.
The biggest problem to memorize the English version, but when I try to learn the Indonesian one, it's like, oh, it's nearly the same. Very simple.
Okay, terus udah kan udah tahu bulan-bulannya. How to say, now bagaimana cara kita mengucapkan tanggal, bulan, tahun? Karena kan kita udah belajar angka-angka di video sebelumnya. Bagi kalian yang belum nonton di video sebelumnya, kalian bisa klik angka dalam bahasa Polandia. Nah, dan di video kali ini kita belajar bulan dan tahun. Jadi sekarang bagaimana cara pengucapan tanggal, bulan, dan tahun. So, now we need to say the date because we already had in the previous video how to say the numbers, yeah. And this video we said about the month and year, it will be also number, but it will be challenging, right?
Yes.
Tapi sekarang let's start with how to say in Polish if you were born in 1st of January, let's say 2000. 1 January tahun 2000.
1 stycznia.
Okay.
2000 roku.
Oh my god. Okay, jadi ini that's the point that we haven't thought like in the video about saying bulan apa tanggal ke-1.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's not yet in January something, yeah. Like that, right?
You can use that and people will understand, but we also have the different form of approaching dates, like very very specific dates, like birthday dates. So for instance, I would say I was born jestem urodzony pierwszego, because it's the way we address, mm-hmm. specific numbers, like specific dates.
Yeah.
So pierwszego, drugiego, trzeciego, piątego, szesnastego. Mm-hmm. So it's always ego, mm-hmm. at the end. And then you have the months. So mm-hmm. pierwszego stycznia, grudnia, października. So most of them have nia or ka. It depends on the months. The long one, październik, listopad, have ka. The rest, I think, most of them at least have nya. There are a little bit of exceptions from that, like May, maja, stycznia is the same, but lutego, for instance. So.
But how to say the easiest way? Because
The easiest way to do it would be probably by numbers or without even saying the proper form that I just explained. So, for instance, the way that you say like I was born the 1st January of 2000. Moje urodziny 1 styczeń 2000. So, literally the same thing as we talk about previously about numbers. You don't need to conjugate them, you don't need to change them too much. We will understand them and they are actually grammatically correct also. So, just pierwszy albo jeden. Pierwszy is better, like drugi, trzeci, piętnasty, szesnasty. We leaked a little bit about those. And then just the name of the month, or even just the number of the month, and straight up the number of the year.
Okay, jadi that will be another knowledge, ya?
Yeah, it's a little complicated.
Kalau misalnya kalian mau bilang nomor 1, ya jadi tanggal 1, tanggal 2, atau ke 1, ke 2. Ke 1 itu pierwszy. Yeah. Yang kedua?
Drugi.
And 3, 4.
Trzeci, czwarty, piąty, szósty, siódmy, ósmy.
Tapi ya, jadi sebagai contoh kalau kalian mau bilang saya lahir pada tanggal 1 Januari tahun 2000, jadi kalian harus bilang moje urodziny.
Moje urodziny albo
moje urodziny pierwsze
są.
Yeah.
If you say like moje urodziny są pierwszego, but jestem urodzony. Pierwszego, drugiego, trzeciego.
Yeah, the easiest one.
The easiest
the one
would
that
say.
You already mentioned pierwsze, stycznia.
If somebody asks you when are your birthday, you can directly just say like pierwszy styczeń.
Pierwszy styczeń.
And the year.
Okay.
Or drugi, szesnasty, piętnasty, dwa tysiące.
Yeah. What about if you your birthday is 10 of January? Dziesiąte styczeń.
Stycznia, but you can say styczeń too. It's more grammatically correct would be stycznia, but everybody will be okay with styczeń. Dziesiąty styczeń.
Okay, wow.
But, or dziesiąty pierwszy.
Yeah. But don't worry, it will be for the, like, you know, later.
You don't need to address us like super grammatically correct, because you literally can just say numbers. Just numbers. If somebody asks you like what's your birthday, or like when have you been born, if you just tell like jeden, dwanaście, dwa tysiące, we will understand it. It's still okay. It's not a big deal. Not as if you want to write a letter or something
betul,
like that.
Betul. Yeah. Jadi jangan khawatir, jangan bingung dulu kalau misalnya dengan yang seperti ini, karena memang belajar bahasa Polandia itu agak sedikit complicated nanti. Tapi yang penting kalian harus tahu dulu nama hari dan nama bulan tersebut. Oke? Okay? Wah, kayaknya sekarang kita udah, I think we already covered everything. Yeah.
Yeah. In case you have any kind of questions or doubts, let us know in the comments below, and we will try our best to help you and maybe make a new video or just answer to the questions.
Yeah, kalau misalnya kalian ada pertanyaan sesuai yang Adam bilang tadi, kalian bisa komen di bawah, atau kalau misalnya kalian punya ide video apa selanjutnya, kalian juga bisa komen di bawah. Nanti kita bakal buat video dan sebisa mungkin kita bakal buat sesering mungkin video belajar bahasa Polandia. Oke? Jadi aku harap ini membantu sedikit informasinya ke kalian, dan jangan lupa tolong di like, comment, dan di subscribe video channel Valeri Polandia sekali lagi. Okay, thank you so much. Dan terima kasih sudah nonton. Thank you, bye-bye.